So is this the best time of year to be taking scion wood?
Yeah, absolutely. Traditionally, grafting is done during the cold winter months from about January 1st through the end of February. So now is the optimum time to be out here collecting cuttings. So this is a dwarf ginkgo here that I'm going to be grafting today, and we're out here collecting some scion wood. And really all I look for when I'm collecting scion wood is I try to avoid the most vigorous shoots because they're usually the thickest and I often don't have rootstock that are big enough to accommodate it. So I try to select some of these kind of medium grade vigorous shoots, if you will. Mm-hmm. And all I'm looking for is stem sections that are about 6 inches long. I try to find a shoot that's got a nice straight bottom to it. It makes it a lot easier to cut, and something that's got pretty sizable internode areas, the areas between the buds, and that's usually where I make the cuts. So this is the kind of material that I'm after. And as soon as I collect it, it goes in a plastic bag to avoid any kind of drying out.
This is a branch that I would normally prune out. Is
yeah.
Is that one that you would take?
Yeah, so absolutely. You could go on the interior and I would remove that whole stem.
Right.
And this longer branch, I could get two or three scions out.
Oh,
I see. It doesn't have to be the terminal
No,
buds.
It can be back into older wood. And in some instances, the older branches from previous years are easier to cut.
It's interesting.
Sometimes they're not.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Right. So once I'm done collecting, I try to always have a plan of how many I need to collect when I'm out there.
Right.
And I immediately label everything with pencil. Pencil doesn't fade. As a nurseryman, we don't have an accurate name on the plant, then we can't sell it. So
yeah.
Labeling is critical. So this is Spring Grove Ginkgo.
Was that hard on the mother plant?
Yeah, you know, you have to always balance how much you're removing, but on a plant this size, it's, you know, a few stems is not going to be mm-hmm. a problem. Yeah. So when we have something brand new and we want to propagate it and we end up taking too much off of it, that it can really stress that mother plant. Yeah, the more you take off, the more of a challenge it is for the plant to recover.
There are some root grafts that fail, isn't that correct? I've seen
ornamental
cherries, for instance.
Absolutely, and it usually has to do with the relationship of the graft partners, the rootstock and the scion. They need to be really closely related, either the same species or very close relatives. You can't just go out and graft a white pine onto an apple or something like that. They're too distant.
Yeah. Right.
And usually when you have a graft that fails, it's related to their compatibility, it's
right.
called. And often people try to push the limits of the relationships there, and as a result, we do occasionally see some failures.
Yeah, yeah. Now, you pointed out earlier this this pecan that onto which has been grafted a shagbark hickory.
Yeah.
And those are two, that same genus, different species.
Exactly. These are completely compatible. The graft has been there for 20 years.
Yeah.
But the bark looks a little funny. You can see the smooth, kind of scaly bark of the pecan against the shaggy shagbark hickory bark up there, and it's kind of interesting. But it's a talking point for us in the garden, which is part of what it's all about for
right.
us.